everybody, and welcome to another edition of JBD Worthy News. I am your host, Greg Schwem. Thank you so much for stopping by. Maybe you stopped by because you've heard about the JB Dondolo Foundation. Maybe some of you stopped by because you were just happened to be surfing YouTube and you said, what the heck is this? What is JBD Worthy News? What is JBD for that matter? JBD stands for JB Dondolo. That is a nonprofit organization that is dedicated to making people aware of a very serious problem worldwide. That is the lack of access to clean drinking water. So many communities around the country and around the world struggle with something that is so simple, so basic to so many of us, and that is clean drinking water. They don't have it. They go days without having it. They have to go find it somewhere, and they have to bring it back to their communities. And that is something that JB Dondolo wants to eliminate. We do it through awareness. We do it through education. We do it through donations. And you are welcome at any time to make a donation to this cause at jbdondolo.org. JB Dondolo not only provides awareness, but we do it in a lot of very creative ways, which we're going to be talking about. One of those ways in this episode, we are going to be talking about the recently launched Music for Water campaign. That is a campaign where unknown songwriters, and you might be one of them, can submit songs and possibly get a distribution deal from Grand Mountain International Records. That's right, you could become a recording star just because you wrote and submitted a song that has to do with water. And that's a very broad subject. You could write a song about water from a stream, water from a waterfall, the tears that you might cry on a regular basis. That's all water, right? So we're going to be talking about that. Stick around. Now, if you watched the first episode, and by the way, this is our inaugural season, so that's a reason to keep watching. I know what happens. A lot of times people say to me, Greg, you have to watch this great new show on Netflix or HBO. And the first thing I say is, how many seasons? And if they say seven, I say, I'm not watching because I don't have that much time. But this is our inaugural season, and this is only episode two, so there's no reason that you shouldn't be watching. If you watched our first episode, you know that I'm a stand-up comedian, and I thought it would be a great idea to start out every episode with some fun, with some laughs, with some humor, and I have to admit, it's been very difficult to come up with funny material in the last 2 weeks. As I record this episode, Hurricane Laura is lashing the Texas and the Louisiana coast. Those people are going to need our prayers, and they're going to need a lot of help when this storm is over. We have ongoing violence in places like Kenosha, in Minneapolis, in Portland, in Chicago, where I live. This is violence that basically is the result of two different sides who want their voices to be heard, and they need to be heard, and we have to sit down and figure out how we're going to hear all sides. And we could talk about that all day and all night, but that's not what I want to talk about. I have two very special guests who are devoted to the Music for Water campaign in very different ways, and you're going to hear from both of them and what they have to say. So let's get right to it, shall we? My first guest is a singer, a songwriter, an actress, a model, and we were lucky enough to get her as a judge for the Music for Water competition. Please say hello to Amanda Abizaid. Where are you Skyping in from today, Amanda?
I live in Los Angeles.
All right, so very good.
It's nice and warm, and we have humidity now, which is different for us. But, you know, I'm grateful I have a place, and I'm healthy and safe, and I can't ask for more. So
exactly. Okay, very good. Why don't you start by telling me a little bit about yourself? As I said, I read your website. The first thing that struck me, you are the product of an American mother and a Mexican Lebanese dad. So yes. It sounds like you had some wild parties growing up.
Yeah, you would think, right? Well, I was, my father's Mexican Lebanese, my mom's American. They met at Cornell University, and my mom got on a boat at 19 years old and went to Lebanon and married my dad and had six kids, and I was one of them. So I lived
Where do you fall in there? Oldest, youngest, in the middle?
I'm number five, okay. The youngest of five girls, and then I have a younger brother. So we actually used to sing a lot together as a family. My oldest sister, Cindy, was an opera singer, and she we're 10 years apart, so she kind of used me as the guinea pig to sing with my four sisters and kind of told me, you know, hey, if you want to sing with us and you sing this part. And it really taught me a lot about melodies and music at a very young age. I wanted to be a part of the group. I wanted to hang out with my sisters and sing. So I learned really fast to fit in and to blend. So I really became a really great with harmonies first off.
Mm-hmm.
And that was my first love in singing. And then when I came to so I had a great life in Lebanon. We came to the States because of the Civil War and grew up in Poughkeepsie, New York. That's where my mom's from. And then we moved to Great Falls, Virginia. And my dad stayed in Lebanon. I kept singing, and we would every now and then my sisters and I would get together and sing, but then everybody started to do their own thing. But music was just something that never left my heart, and all my life that's all I ever wanted to be was a singer.
I should probably tell that's everybody okay. We are recording on your phone, so yeah. Not having an earthquake out there in Los Angeles. I know you're trying to work
I'm
your
so
phone
sorry,
and
yeah.
That's what we're dealing with here with all this virtual technology, but no problem. I want to jump ahead now a little bit. How did you get involved in the Music for Water campaign? Did JB Dondolo approach you, vice versa, or was it a mutual meeting? Tell me.
I went to the Philippines about 5 years ago. And I stayed with, met the Ayata native indigenous people of the Philippines. And they live in the Pinatubo volcanic mountain range. They don't have water. They walk down the mountain to the Lahar River every day to get these huge jugs of water that they then walk up again, a mile mm-hmm. hike to the
right.
village again. It's insane. And then, of course, they collect the rainwater from the sky. They have a way to collect it through the roofs of their, huts that they have and stuff.
Sure.
So, but I mean, they, the nonprofit that I went with, HelpPhilippinesSchools.org, were raising money to put in a water pump because they really need that, So mm-hmm. I saw firsthand how challenging and how incredible, these people had to live to get water. And I want to be on board with this because this is huge. I mean,
right.
We have to have running water.
Absolutely. And some of your songs have very powerful messages in them. I know that your latest album is called Walking in Twos, and that's also a song track on there. And I've listened to yeah. that song. And give me a little background about that song, how you came to write it, and who you were writing it for.
So I started writing that song from a script that a friend of mine gave me that she wanted me to write the song for her film. And then the film didn't happen. So then I went to the Philippines and I had the beginnings of this song called Walking in Twos. And I played it for the kids in the village and they flipped. Now they don't speak English.
Mm-hmm.
So they flipped out and I thought, oh, wow, this is a message that's getting across even through a different language. I've got something here,
Yeah.
So I've, excuse me. I came back to LA and I really wanted to finish the song. And I've known Stephen Stills for many years now. I met him through his daughter, Jennifer Stills. We used to sing together at the gig.
Stephen Stills of Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young.
Yes.
One of my
yes.
favorite bands.
In yes. Yes.
Kind of combination.
Well, he's amazing. He's amazing. He's an amazing person. And he supports children. And so I said to him, hey, I told him the story. And I'm a Buddhist, and I believe strongly in world peace, especially coming from Lebanon, with all of the different wars and situations over there. I've always, really been interested in bringing people peacefully around the world through my music and just through the person that I am, through behavior and unity with people. And so this song was really something that, for me on a personal level I was hoping to bring personal relationships together through the people that I knew and also just around the world to get that unity message across. So Stephen supports children and I said, hey, I'm working with this nonprofit right now to raise money to get a water pump and school education supplies. And would you play on the track? And of course, I've known him for many years. For many years, I've been thinking, gosh, how am I going to ask him to play on one of my songs? And I just felt like, wasn't sincere. It just, I just didn't have a sincere enough reason I felt to approach him,
sure,
you know, to say, oh, you want to play on one of my songs, you know? So I felt, you know, this is a really good reason to ask him to play on a song. This is a passion of mine to help these kids, and they need water and school supplies. And so he said, yeah, sure.
You're kind of in the Stephen Stills category for Music for Water in the fact that people are looking for your approval. People who are submitting songs via this contest, you will be one of the judges, as I said earlier.
Yeah.
What advice would you give for someone who is submitting a song? And of course, one of the requirements is that it is a water themed song. So if there's somebody out there thinking, I haven't written it yet, but I would really like to get involved, what advice would you give for them?
Well, I think it's a great opportunity for a good cause to be involved in the project. When you're asked by a company like JB Dondolo to write a song for them, mm-hmm. I mean, being asked to write a song for anyone is an amazing opportunity.
And
so
that
in itself is great, you know, to have this opportunity. And then for such an important necessity in life to have water. I would say to make the song yours, really truly love the song that you're writing with the message that you want to get across in a fun, musical, not teaching, preaching way,
mm-hmm.
you know, but from your heart, any aspect of water that comes to you that you're inspired by, that you think would, you know, inspire other people to listen to and encourage them to support. So, but it needs to be fun. It needs to be from the heart.
Well, we're happy to have you on board. And thanks so much for spending a few minutes with myself and with our viewers. We can't wait to hear the music. I'm sure you can't wait to hear the music.
I can't wait.
Right. And we can't wait to see who's going to be crowned the winner. So thank you so much for volunteering and doing what you do. And best of luck in your career.
Thanks, Greg. It's a pleasure to meet you, and I'm really honored to be on board. Thank you so much.
All right.
That was a lot of fun. Now, I know the technology between Amanda and myself was a little shaky at times, but hey, that's Zoom, that's Skype, that's Google Hangouts. That's the way we communicate in this COVID-19 era. We really need to start talking to one another face-to-face. I miss that. I miss hotels. I miss mini bars. Even the ones where when you check in, they make it sound like the mini bar's a loaded weapon. I checked into one not long ago. They said, Mr. Schwem, just so you know, the mini bar is motion activated. So if you move anything, if you touch anything, if you look at the cashews in a yearning manner, you will be charged. And don't think they weren't serious. I went to check out. They said, Mr. Schwem, that'll be $25 for the Snickers bar. I said, I didn't eat a Snickers bar. They said, yeah, but you thought about it. Let's go to the video. Okay, before I bring on my next guest, I want to talk about where all the money for the Music for Water campaign is going and all the people that make donations. That is all going to the Navajo Nation. That is the charity that we have chosen to help provide clean drinking water and other products and services that they desperately need. You should Google or Wikipedia Navajo Nation. You will find that it is a 27,000 square mile tract of land that is... takes up parts of three states, Arizona, New Mexico, and Utah, and more than 173,000 people live on that 27,000 square miles. So they got a lot of room to social distance, that's for sure. But they also, kidding aside, they need our help. They need clean drinking water, and they need, again, goods and services that you and I take for granted every day. So the Navajo Nation is the recipient of all of the money raised through the Music for Water campaign. And with that, it is time to meet my next guest. This gentleman here is part of an organization that is doing great things as we all strive to stay clean and healthy and exercise good hygiene and good sanitation in this pandemic. Please say hello to the Chief Product and Technology Officer of Disinfect and Shield, Patrick Haddad. Patrick, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, no problem, Greg. I'm happy to be here.
All right, very good. Now, the first thing I want to do is talk a little bit about this product, Disinfect and Shield. This is a product that maybe a lot of people in the mainstream haven't heard about, but I know you're doing wonderful things as we, as I said in the introduction, struggle to combat COVID. Now, I happen to have a surface cleaner right here and product placement there, Patrick, and
yeah,
also a hand sanitizer. Why don't you tell me a little bit about this this product, the background of it, and also what makes it different from some of the maybe the mainstream hand sanitizers and hygiene products that you see in, say, a Target or a CVS?
Sure, I would love to. So again, our main products is a disinfectant as well as an 8-hour hand sanitizer. Mm-hmm. The reason we're really passionate about this and into these products is because, number one, all of our products are eco-friendly and green. And their other differentiation on what you're used to in the market is they last a long time without having to use any harsh chemicals. Mm-hmm. So a good example of that is our normal hand sanitizer evaporates within 4 or 5 seconds. It's alcohol-based. Ours lasts 8 hours plus with really good data and testing up to 24 hours. And it's also alcohol free. And there's quite a bit of information and studies about how dangerous alcohol is to take on the skin in addition to just drinking it. So I tell them we last thousands of times longer than normal sanitizer and we're a lot safer. It's a pretty easy sell on that side.
Mm-hmm. I think you're definitely seeing the fears people have as children are going back to school and you're wondering about how you're going to sanitize schools and keep kids safe. How long has this product been on the market? And I guess, no offense, but why haven't we heard more about it?
That's a great question. I mean, my company got behind this about 5 months ago. The product has been in a smaller chemical lab. It's been out for a few years now. And really the reason people haven't heard about it is people haven't really had the need to open up and accept the need for disinfectants and hand sanitizer on the mainstream. It was a nice to have on a small basis. And once we discovered this product line was frankly so superior to anything on the mainstream, we realized it was our company's mission to get it out to the mainstream and say, this is a better way to sanitize. This is a better way to disinfect. And everyone else should know this, not like we do.
Mm-hmm. Now on your website, you make a pretty powerful statement in the fact that you say that this is successful in combating the COVID-19 germs. It doesn't say it cures the coronavirus. Let's make that very clear. But you have had some success in killing coronavirus germs. Now, what studies do you have to back that up?
Sure. We have very strong studies by major universities for both the hand sanitizer and the disinfectant. Very recently, we have COVID-19 specific studies using a study with a popular surrogate of COVID-19, which is pretty much a safer way to test, that shows the disinfectant can last 28 days plus on a surface and the hand sanitizer can last 24 hours. So this is all very recent in the last month. These are studies that are very easy to read and take in. And companies have been beating down our doors now when they understand we really can back up what we say.
Okay. Now let's talk a little bit about your partnership with JB Dondolo. How did you get affiliated with the JB Dondolo Foundation? And what are you hoping to do for them?
Sure. We had a mutual friend that's very trusted on our side that introduced us and told us a lot about what they're doing in regards to water treatment, in regards to overall helping the world. And we thought it was a great position for ourselves to be affiliated with a company like this, as well as helping you guys out. I mean, we have the same mission, you know, social responsibility, making things cleaner and safer and better. So I thought that both of our company objectives aligned and it'd be a great opportunity for both of us to educate in each other's spaces and each other's networks.
Mm-hmm. And you are a partner in JB Dondolo's Music for Water campaign. Of course, all the funds raised for that are going to benefit the Navajo Nation out in Arizona. Have you seen firsthand some of the areas that are so in need of this product? Have you actually been out in the field? And can you give us an example?
Yeah, so I have been out in the field. One of the biggest areas that I see needed is really Las Vegas as a whole. We went out to Las Vegas and we noticed that there's so much, number one, people, so much hands and activity on so many places and such high tourism that we think it's one of the biggest areas that truly need to protect from thousands of different people shuffling in and out, that this entire industry and area is dependent on it for the revenue. It's tourism and people coming in that are going to be shuffling and cycling through, which is a lot of hands and a lot of exposure going on.
I mentioned that I have this product now, that I am heading out to Tennessee tomorrow, and you'll be happy to know that this is going with me, both this and this. It's going to be sprayed in my car on all the surfaces. And
well, I think that would give confidence to whoever's going to be around after you, and I think you need to educate people coming after. I mean, they need some protocol. In your case, you're going on a drive, you know, protect yourself. And if we all work together, we're going to get through this thing and things are going to slightly, you know, tighten down to a point where we have to be careful with being able to open up a bit more. So, mm-hmm.
All right. Well, the website is disinfectandshield.com. You can see it right below there on your screen. Patrick, thank you so much for what you're doing with the JB Dondolo Foundation and much success to you and stay safe.
All right. Thanks a lot, Greg. It was great to be a part of this. I wish you all the best of luck and have a good one.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Patrick. And that completes another edition of JBD Worthy News. Thank you for stopping by. I hope you gained an awareness of the JB Dondolo Foundation and what we are fighting for. Again, that is clean drinking water. And if you are intrigued with the Music for Water campaign and you are a musician or you know of a musician that wants to contribute through their music and their words, then please let everybody know. Let them know. Let everybody know about Music for Water. Encourage people to submit songs. The contest is open through September 30th. The top five winning songs will get a one-time distribution deal through Grand Mountain International Records. That's right. This time next year, there could be a star on the horizon, and that star could be being interviewed and saying, hey, I owe it all to Music for Water and JB Dondolo. If you would like more information about what we do, you can visit jbdondolo.org. If you want more information about the Music for Water campaign, that's jbdondolo.org/musicforwater. Please make a donation. Make a difference in somebody's life. Subscribe to all of our social media feeds. You will see them at the end of this episode. And we'll see you back in a couple of weeks. Stay safe, everybody.